disagreements philosophically. It's is counting on
the Mike Gallagher Show, weekdays at 9, right before Dennis Prager at noon on AM 1250. The Answer.
Mick Jagger is 76. I just thought I should mention that. And he's still out there prancing around the stage. And I just went to him and said, Mick, how you doing? I've been with a band since 1905. I just thought you'd be interested, and we're still packing them in. Anyway, I heard an interesting story about how the band was formed. I don't remember this guy's name, but he was approached by a couple of guys named Lennon and McCartney in the early 60s in Liverpool. They had a band, and they wanted to see if this guy would be interested in being their manager. He said no. He told them, you know, boy bands, I'm not big on them. I don't think you're a thing anymore. I don't see anything happening with it. So a little while later, he spotted Mick Jagger and his boys playing somewhere, and he hooked up with the Rolling Stones, and here they are almost 60 years later, still filling stadiums. I saw in 2006, after the 2000 dog and a frisbee test, meaning a dog and a frisbee would be more entertaining. The most nauseating one I saw in person was Diana Ross at Super Bowl 40 out in Phoenix. She came in on a helicopter. And they sounded great. Of course, Mick was young then. He was only 62. So happy birthday to Mick Jagger. And his gift to me is that I was able to just talk about him for a couple of minutes here instead of Bob Mueller. We're going to talk about cops in our second half hour with Heather McDonald. She wrote a book. You've seen the videos that have been out there going around with these kids dumping buckets of water on the cops, and they just do nothing. Some cases hitting them in the head with the bucket, and the cops just stand there and take it. Heather's going to have some strong things to say about that based on the research she did for her book. But hey, it is Friday, and that means it's time for this.
And now, it's time for The Jerk of the Week, starring John Steigerwald.
Well, you know, Alexandria overrated Cortez and the rest of the squad. They make it kind of tough on us here at The Jerk of the Week. We could pick one of them every week and not feel like we were shirking our duties. Actually, we could pick the whole squad and just, you know, make it a multiple award every week. But, sorry, I have to give it to... It seems to be getting... Every day that... You know, she married her brother to scam the immigration authorities, but that's not why she's our jerk of the week. That's it for saying this.
Our country should be more fearful of white men across our country because they are actually causing most of the deaths within this country. We should be profiling, monitoring, and creating policies to fight the radicalization of white men.
Yeah, white men are causing most of the deaths. Actually, they're not. White people are... ...percent of the population, and that's according to the Department of Justice. And around the world, according to the Global Terrorism Index, 66 deaths were caused by white terrorist groups. I think that was in 2017. But there were something like 18,000...
Visit WindowsRUsPittsburgh.com.
Close to retirement? Experienced a nice Trumponomics bump in your portfolio? Well, we know the market goes up, and unfortunately, we also know it goes down. Don't risk your retirement to market whims. Learn how you can lock in those gains today by spending time with the team at Marley Fund. With all the changes in tax laws, be sure. To see just how. Or visit them at MarleyFG.com.
Takes care of needs, that's organized. This will be the fourth Miracle League field that will be built. Now we got four places to be able to travel, so it broadens the whole interest of sports. It's just terrific for a community to do that.
There's a buddy system I thought was pretty impressive. What's that all about?
Kids with special needs have a buddy, a child who's in school. It's like having an older brother or sister involved with you. So it's really good in that everybody.
Talk again about this project.
They told you it couldn't be done, but that just. Just smiled and said, "Oh, yeah? Watch us." When you need a large format printing partner who can provide high quality visual graphics in stunning detail, from trade show displays to outdoor signs, 3M brand vehicle wrap for your fleet, to window graphics, banners, and decals, SpeedPro Pittsburgh South can handle most jobs in 2 days or less, and can roll with last minute. SpeedProPGHSouth.com.
What is it costing you in vet bills for that convenience of just pulling? But a good coat, bright eyes, and a great attitude.
Come to Dynavite for help.
DynoVite.com.
I found his raw meat diet on Dynavite.com.
With just the raw meat and the eggs and the Dynavite and the Super Omega on top of it.
Shots. Buy two, get one free.
It just balances out his body and his mind and his spirit.
Adding Dynavite to the diet has every single dog in my kennel looking better than they have ever looked.
Their skin is so much better now that they're on the raw diet. I don't even give them the kibble anymore.
DynoVite.com.
This is the John Steigerwald here.
Well, we've been talking about the unbelievable stupidity of female athletes having to compete with men who say they're women and transgender women who are actually biological men or males. In the case of high school, we talked about it a lot here about how ridiculous it is that they are able to compete against women. And it's a big thing with me. Disagree with that. I have no problem with women's sports. It's great that there are women playing it, not playing sports now, and girls in high school. But It's the idea that you have that you would have a daughter who would be competing as a track athlete, a runner, a sprinter, and she would have to show up at a regional or state track meet and see a guy standing there against them, and she has no chance to win. So it's a story that's been out there for a long time. A new study came out that. And this is the thing that really stuns me, is that anybody needs a study to tell you that that is stupid. The problem, there are Democrats out there, and the Daily Caller had a piece on it today. That's why I wanted to talk about it. And won unanimously by the Democrats in the House of Representatives, U.S. House. And so we have tried to contact both Connor Lamb and Mike Doyle, two local Democrat representatives, to get their, just how they feel. They both, because it was unanimous, so they either didn't vote or they voted. And more and more you're seeing it pop up in the news where, you know, Nancy Pelosi, somebody will tell you how wonderful it is and that they're so happy that it's, you know, on its way to the Senate or whatever. I don't even know where it is in Congress right now. But the Democrats are very much behind it. And we have sent emails. We've made phone calls to the congressman. And the only thing we've ever got is a one-sentence response from Matt, who's the media guy for Mike Doyle. And we asked him for a statement on what I'm talking about right now, the Equality Act's effect on students, not students, girls who have to compete against men, and whether he's okay with that. He voted for the Equality Act, and that's going to be part of it. You're not going to be able to discriminate based on identity. And he sent us back Doyle. We asked him about it. So we've since sent them another email. Aaron Byrne, the producer, sent another email. I told you about it a couple of days ago, asking him to comment on the stupid, idiotic, ridiculous story about the guy who wanted to have a Brazilian wax done by women up in Canada. And there's some other being a predator and going after young girls. So that the more will come out about that. But that's not what I want to talk about today. I just want to let you know that there is a Congress, or at least two congressmen within the sound of my voice here today, who refuse to even just give us a one sentence, yeah, I'm okay with that, or no, I'm not thrilled with that, but, you know, the entire act, there's many things they could say. Nothing should not be one of their responses. They owe it to their constituents, because there are people out there who have girls competing in sport. How would you like to have a girl who has worked, you know, for years to get to the point where she might be a state champion, or, you know, not even to that point, but to get to the point where she might get a scholarship and manage to perform in a meet because she's lost to a man, and she didn't go to the regionals, and, you know, so she didn't get a scholarship. So that's the kind of stuff that's happening. So the Daily Caller, the headline is, Democrats denied transgender athletes have advantages in women's sports. Science says they're wrong. So these idiots have been asked about it. And these people who know, including the person who just made our joke, jerk of the week, Ilhan Omar, she, as I actually said, that's ridiculous. That's just you're just a bigot, and you're transphobic, and for anybody to say that, how much do you think she knows about sports? Less than not much. So these Democrats have come out and saying that it's dumb. that, you know, that you shouldn't have to worry about it. The paper is called Trans Women in Elite Sport: Scientific and Ethical Considerations. And it concluded that male athletes who identify as transgender women, quote, intolerable advantage over their female competitors. Intolerable. Remember how, don't we hear about how tolerant you're supposed to be if you're a liberal? The authors, two bioethics professors and a physiology professor, noted that, quote, there is very little scientific evidence to support, the argument that hormone therapy will mitigate the advantage trans women may have in comparison with cis. Quote, healthy young men did not lose significant muscle mass or power when their circulating testosterone levels were reduced to below International Olympic Committee guidelines for 20 weeks. What the Olympics require, if you are going to compete as a woman and you have high levels of testosterone, you have to reduce the amount of testosterone in your system somehow for 20 weeks before you're able to compete. So that's what these trans men, women, I should say, have to go through if they are competing in the Olympics. And it says, moreover, retention of muscle mass could be compensated for by training or other ergogenic methods. In addition, the phenomenon of muscle memory means muscle mass and strength can be rebuilt with previous strength exercise, making it easier to regain muscle mass later in life, even after long intervening periods of inactivity and mass loss. Now, what they're getting at here is that they're saying that some things never change. If you are a biological man and you think you're transgender, transitioning to a woman, you may reduce your testosterone levels, and I'm guessing you may even have surgery, but you're still going to have the same lungs and the same a male that are going to give you an advantage over women. That's not going to change no matter what how much makeup you put on, how many surgeries you get, or how many pills you take. The authors noted that indirect effects of testosterone will not be altered by hormone therapy. For example, hormone therapy will not alter bone structure, this is what I was just talking about, lung volume, or heart size of the trans woman athlete, especially if she transitions post-puberty, so natural advantages include stroke volume and maximal oxygen uptake will be maintained. So the author's solution is to eliminate binary gender-based categories in sports altogether, rather than excluding biological males from female events. I don't know what that means, but I think it means no men's sports, no women's sports, just sports. And if that's the case, that's exactly what everybody has been saying about what will happen if you start allowing men to compete against women. More and more transgender women, actually men, male biological men, will start to severely damage all the progress that has been made by women in sports. But as the Daily Caller points out, this is the Democrats in Congress have always downplayed this and said, "Nah, you're ridiculous. Don't worry about the Equality Act. This won't affect the women and the men don't, the transgender women don't have any advantage." This is what our jerk of the week, Ilhan Omar, said. Trans women have a direct competitive advantage, in quotes, she has it, is not that was in January, in a letter. She sent that to Minnesota's Attorney General Keith Ellison, who was charged with sexual assault or some domestic abuse, and somehow it just went away. But he's the Attorney General in Minnesota. She urged him to investigate the powerlifting for barring male weightlifters from female events. A man won a powerlifting event not too long ago, and Ellison told her that it was out of his jurisdiction. And then here's Jerry Nadler. He doesn't look like much of an athlete to me. It's just me. You ever seen Jerry? I don't think he's played a lot of sport. I'm just a wild guess. But I have a feeling he doesn't know a whole lot about sports. This is what Jerry said. Many states have sexual orientation and gender identity non-discrimination laws, and all still have and really smart people. Bye. Rep. Katie Hill also downplayed concerns about, you know, the effect on female athletes. This is fear-mongering about trans women playing in sports. Are you kidding me? That's what she said. Are you kidding me? And nobody, and this is what drives me crazy about this. I don't need any really smart people, scientists, to tell me that this is stupid. This is where we are now on the planet Earth. That you can look at something and it'd be just glaringly obvious, like a guy wanting his, you know what, waxed by women and saying that have them do it. That is just so stupid and insane on its face. But you're something wrong with you if you even question it. So this is fear mongering. Trans women playing in sports. Are you kidding me? So the House bill passed in May with unanimous support from Democrats. And the Senate is not going to vote for it. So it's going to get stuck there. But the Democrat presidential candidates, oh, I think all 20 of them, or how many, I don't remember how they are, more than 20, I think now, 24, whatever it is, they are all saying that it's not a problem. And I don't know when they're going to, is there ever going to be a debate on somewhere other than CNN or MSNBC? Because if not, I mean, if it doesn't happen in a debate, where who can just get these idiots on the record and have them say that they have no problem with this this Equality Act. And again, Connor Lamb and Mike Doyle, they voted for this. You just heard the stupidity from these other people. They're right in there with them if they voted for it. And you heard what the scientists said. It's absolutely, they said it gives them an intolerant advantage. Intolerant. I think that means you're not supposed to tolerate it. And if you have a brain and you know anything about sports, you wouldn't tolerate it for 5 seconds. And it's going to be a law. It's going to be a law. Well, it won't be if the Democrats it's already insane. But you know, you have the two biologically male run, they dominate. NCAA Women's Championship in Division II women's 400 meter hurdles, and it says NCAA policy is that male athletes who identify as transgender can compete on women's teams if they suppress their testosterone levels for a full calendar year. You just heard what these scientists said, that doesn't matter. It still gives the men intolerant advantage over women, intolerating it. Not only are they tolerating it, they're dismissing it. So that's where we are. Just thought I'd give you an update on that, and it makes me wanna, you know what, puke. We'll be back.
With SRN News, I'm Keith Peters in Washington. President Trump says Guatemala is signing an agreement to restrict asylum applications to the United States from Central America.
The agreement would require migrants, including Salvadorans and Hondurans, who cross into Guatemala on their way to the U.S., to apply for protections in Guatemala instead of at the U.S. border. President Trump called it a very big day.
It's going to provide safety for legitimate asylum seekers and stop asylum fraud and abuses.
The deal could potentially ease the crush of migrants overwhelming the U.S. immigration system. Greg Clugston, The White House.
President Trump is also pressuring the World Trade Organization to stop letting China and other economies receive lenient treatment under global trade.
Skeptical, like I was, about ordering Relief Factor. Pat Boone again for this wonderful 100% drug-free supplement designed to help your own body lower or eliminate occasional aches and pains due to aging, exercise, everyday living. I'm not skeptical any longer. The 3-week quick start is now discounted to only $19.95. Going to factor.com.
Hi, I'm Jay Farner, CEO of Quicken Loans. 30% of Americans who are planning home improvements of $5,000 or more will pay for those renovations with a high-interest credit card. That may not be a great idea. A better idea may be to take cash out of your home with a Quicken Loans 30-year fixed-rate mortgage. The rate today on our 30-year fixed-rate mortgage is 4.125%. APR, 4.22%. Call us today at 800-QUICKEN or go to rocketmortgage.com.
Rate subject to change. 8.88% fee to receive this discounted rate. Call for cost information and conditions. Equal housing lender. License in all 50 states. NMLS number 3030.
Larry Elder wants to know where we are.
There's a poll in Rasmussen. Poll of Democrats. Is it racist for a white politician to criticize the political views of...
Weeknights at 7, right before Joe Walsh at 9 on AM 1250. The answer.
Community Bank.
City Mission.
Number 1 Cochrane.
Highmark Stadium.
Peters Township Community Center.
Angelo's Restaurant.
What do...
Nello Construction.
Design and build with one company.
Nello Construction.
Full service construction from the ground up.
Renovation. Expansion.
Nello Construction.
Keep the outside noise outside. More peace and better rest for your family. Exceptional noise control for a quieter home. Right now, get 50% off installation or 18 months, no payments, no interest. Call 888-77-PELLA. PellaPittsburgh.com.
Do you or your business have financial problems? Are you overwhelmed with debt? And call me, attorney Dennis Spurr, at 412-471-7675. My legal practice concentrates on bankruptcy law, debtor rights, and tax matters. I have over 30 years' experience as a former United States Department of Justice bankruptcy attorney and lawyer in private practice. I've represented thousands of cases faced with financial problems and lawsuits. Reorganize and get a fresh start. Call 412-471-7675 or visit my website at DennisSpurr.com.
Stuck in traffic? We've got the answer.
Outbound on the Parkway East is heavy. Boulevard Allies to Edgewood, Swiss Vail Parkway West slowing down inbound Carnegie to the Fort Pitt Tunnel. Slow on the Parkway North outbound from Camp Horn Road up to 79. Northbound 79 solid from the Parkway North to Cranberry. Lots of closures for the Picklesburg Festival. That includes the Roberto Clemente Bridge, parts of Federal Street and Fort Duquesne Boulevard. That's a look at traffic. I'm Jenny Robinson.
AM 1250, The Answer. Weather.
Clear to partly cloudy tonight. It'll be comfortable once again for the overnight hours. Low 64 degrees for tomorrow. Mostly sunny and warm with a high of 85. Clear to partly cloudy tomorrow night. Low 67. Then for Sunday, another warm day starting to turn more humid as well with sunshine and patchy clouds. The high for Sunday, 84 degrees. With your AccuWeather weather forecast, I'm meteorologist Daniel Middle.
You're listening to the John Steigerwald Show on AM 1250, The Answer.
Now, by now, you've probably seen videos that have gone viral showing young blacks in a couple of New York neighborhoods, cops, as they're trying to do their jobs. I know if you've been watching Fox, you've seen them. I can't be that confident that you have if you're watching MSNBC or CNN. But when I saw them, I thought of Heather MacDonald, who wrote a book called The War on Cops. And we've had her on the show to talk about it before, and Heather joins us now. Heather, thanks for coming. So I am assuming you've seen the videos I'm talking about here.
Sure.
And I'm guessing that after all the research you've done on this subject, you had a stronger reaction than most people. What was your reaction? I'm guessing surprise isn't one of them.
No, this is just a continuation of what's been happening since the growth of this false narrative that the police are racist, that we're living through an epidemic of racially biased shootings of black men, which is simply not the case. And we've already seen cops cursing people, you know, the smartphones right in the officers' faces, just incredible abuse, and officers are driving on by. What we saw in this video as well is just the passivity of the officers. That, too, is not surprising because officers are terrified that if they actually enforce the law and do so legally, never could misrepresent their interaction with that person get picked up by CNN and their career is over. So you do have a demoralized police force across the country thanks to the narrative brought into major prominence during the Obama administration. And although the Black Lives Matter movement is no longer the primary focus of the media because they're so in resistance mode now, the effects of that live on at the local level. And we're really playing with fire here, John, in so delegitimating the authority of our law enforcement officers.
I don't think that those videos serve as a really good recruiting tool for police either.
Recruiting is way down in any case. Somebody said it's not a recruiting pool, it's an applicant pool, it's an applicant trickle. And you see officers now, departments junking requirements, getting rid of literacy tests, drug tests, saying, oh, criminal record, no problem. Also, misguided pressure that you have to have, think about the racial demographics of your police force, which I think is an irrelevancy, but we've got to get more black officers. In order to get more black officers or make them available and remotely eligible, you have departments now, as I say, that are getting rid of some pretty darn important prerequisites to become, but this is certainly going to make that problem even worse.
It's interesting that you mentioned that it doesn't matter, because something else I saw in the last day or two, which made me think of you, because I've spoken to you about this and I know about your book and everything. I don't know if you're familiar with the study that was done by these two professors at Michigan State and the University of Maryland. You know about that?
Sure.
Yeah, and they basically come right out and say that based on their study, and I think you beat them to the punch on most of this stuff, because none of this was new to me, because I've spoken to you. They said that it makes no difference to the racial ethnic makeup of the police force makes no difference.
This in the book over and over again. Here's what matters: the amount of crime in a neighborhood. If you have a neighborhood where officers are confronting violent, armed, and resisting suspects, officer use of force is there. There's no evidence that white officers are more likely to shoot blacks than black officers. And some of the studies I cite in my book show that, in fact, black officers are holding a gun than white Philadelphia police officers. So, again, it is amazing the persistence of this narrative.
Yeah, we're talking to Heather McDonald. She wrote a book called The War on Cops, How the New Attack on Law and Order Makes Everyone Safe. But you also wrote a book, and that's your most recent book, Diversity Delusion, How Race and Gender Pandering Corrupt the University and Undermine Our Culture. What you just described there and what I think the Democrat candidates seem to be very good at is racial and especially racial, but both racial and gender pandering. And is that what's going on here?
Well, it's certainly going on in the Democratic side of the race, absolutely.
Yeah.
And you have it's a direct conveyor belt from academic ideology. Students now, the one thing they learn with certainty, nothing else is certain. They if they're not in a science field in college, they're learning basically nothing. But they do learn this, that America is a white supremacist country, that racism is the very definition of the source of all oppression in the world. And you see now these young candidates and their are bringing the academic ideology of identity politics, of victimization, victimology, the elevation of putative absolute height of power, that is transforming our culture at large. And it's a very, very dangerous development, John, because it puts meritocracy at risk. There's not a single institution now that is not junking its meritocratic standards of hiring the best person available in favor of race and gender quotas.
Yeah, and is it...
Well, it's very tough. I would say we have to stop promoting the idea that more and more people should go to college, because at the moment, colleges look pretty darn hopeless.
Oh.
I think the way you reverse it is you have to fight back against the argument that the source of ongoing socioeconomic disparities, racial disparities in our country, is racism. People have to pull on some courage, put on some balls, and say there are massive behavioral disparities that explain those racial disparities, whether it's out-of-wedlock child rearing, where you have now 73% of black children being raised by single mothers, that is a catastrophe, whether it's inattention to school and anti-academic acting white syndrome or involvement in crime, that those are the proximate causes of the ongoing disparities. This is not a racist country. I don't know a single institution that is not twisting itself into knots to try and hire and promote as many underrepresented minorities as possible.
Yeah, I'm an old sports guy, and so I pay close attention to the Colin Kaepernick situation, and you get in trouble, and you're accused of being either racist or, I guess it's mostly racist, if you don't agree with his decision to not stand for the national anthem. And very few people, and I'm willing to do it, but I don't see very many people willing to mention that he was going through all this, whether or not you agree with whether he should have the right to do it or whether he should be fired for doing it. Nobody talks about the fact that it was all based on a false narrative.
Right. Yeah, no, but the media doesn't care about testing that narrative, because it conforms with their worldview as well. But again, John, I cannot stress enough, we are not living through an epidemic of racially biased police shootings of black men. It is not the case. Blacks are actually shot less than their crime rates would predict. As we found recently with this study confirming what I've already written, white police officers are not biased. And the criminal justice system reflects one thing, rates of criminal offending. If blacks are in prison more, it's because they're victimizing more. They have a homicide rate that is 8 times that of whites and Hispanics combined. That is a civil rights problem, because they are killing blacks at a rate that is 6 times higher than whites and Hispanics combined. We should be concerned about those black victims. But in order to talk about them, we're going to have to be honest and talk about the black violent crime rate, street crime rate.
Yeah, and I want university and undermine our culture. We spent biological men competing against women in sports. Now, I said, men competing against women, but you have multiple Democrats, including all the candidates, who have unanimously supported the Equality Act, which would make it illegal to discriminate based on gender. A study came out in the UK, and I talked about it just a few minutes ago, saying that it gives women an intolerant disadvantage. Approved by the Democrats And that's what's going to happen. And the Democrats won't admit that it gives the men who are competing against the women an advantage.
On this, who cares? I don't care. You know, the feminists have fought for years for Title IX and said, to set a record in movement. The trans movement has more power than feminism, but it seems to, I would say in the long term, it's the feminists that are, their agenda is to destroy the notion that there's any difference between
right.
males and females. But, if they really believe this, why don't we have females competing against males in tennis, in running, you know, get rid of any kind.
Well, you know what's scary about this, I've got it here right here, they say that their solution is not to have prevent women from competing against men against women. They just think there should be no difference. This should just be sports, no men or women. That's which is
right. Well, that's fine. Let's bring it on. Bring it on. We'll see how it works.
Yeah.
Again, I really don't care.
Mm-hmm.
If they want to do this, let them do it. It's going to kill them.
Well, what I've said, and I've said this on the air and in some sports shows, and I wrote a column about it. If you and I think alike on this, because I said if they're not willing to stand up, and what they should do is if you line up at the regional track championship, and you look across and you see that you're racing against a male, all the women should just stop and just walk away and let the male run by, because but they don't have the guts to do that.
Right.
And so,
I'm staying out of this. Let them fight out, duke it among themselves. It's one leftist faction against the other, and so I look on with a certain amount of schadenfreude.
I can't let you go. I have a minute left. I can't let you go without asking you about the case of the man in Canada who wants to get a Brazilian. You know that one, don't you?
This is a sort of a wax.
He wants a waxing, and the tribunal, the Human Rights Tribunal in British Columbia, is listening to the case. He wanted 12 women to give him a wax, and he's still a man. And they said, you know, we're not too crazy about doing that. I don't think we want to do that. And he has declared them transphobic. And they didn't dismiss it in 10 seconds. They're actually discussing it.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
That's
good.
Where we are.
Yep.
Yeah.
Again, this is all to be celebrated. You know, the outcome may not be good in the long run. Beat each other up like gladiators in the Colosseum.
I hear you. The stupidity is mind-boggling. Intolerant, actually. Hey, Heather, I really appreciate you being on this. Always do. Thanks for taking the time.
Okay, thank you, John.
Okay, and we'll be back. That's Heather McDonald. Recent storms have done a number on Pittsburgh homes and businesses. This is John Steigerwald. If you've had damage to your roof, windows, siding, or gutters and downspouts, you may be eligible to get them replaced or repaired free of charge. All you have to do is visit WindowsRUsPittsburgh.com for a free inspection from one of their highly trained appraisers. With over 50 years in home remodeling, Windows R Us for roofs, siding, gutters and downspouts, doors, and of course, windows. If damage isn't your issue and you just want something new, you'll love their no-pressure approach and one of the fastest times in the industry. Why pay twice as much with other companies? Visit the area's premier exterior replacement company at WindowsRUsPittsburgh.com. Mention STAG for an additional 10% off at WindowsRUsPittsburgh.com. That's WindowsRUsPittsburgh.com. Windows R Us, proud sponsor of the Jerk of the Week, heard every Friday right here on the John Steigerwald Show. WindowsRUsPittsburgh.com.
Warning, property protected by electric fence. Sharks sighted in water. Warnings are truly handy.
Bridge out.
But you may not always get a warning when it comes to threats to your identity or the personal information on your devices. That's why LifeLock Identity Theft Protection includes Norton Security for even more protection. LifeLock uses proprietary technology to help detect identity threats, like your personal info for sale on the dark web. And Norton Security protects up to 5 devices from ransomware and other online threats. Plus, if you have a problem, our agents will work to fix it. Of course, no one can prevent all identity theft or cybercrime or monitor all transactions at all businesses, but having someone LifeLock with Norton.
A little less fortunate than others, and I think it's just a great opportunity for people to volunteer. And everything for the kids, it takes a little stress for parents. I think it's Pittsburgh's
Moon, Sewickley, Weirton, Steubenville, Beaver County, and surrounding communities. Approximately 100 to 200 children will be eligible to participate, and it'll also serve adults with special needs. So it's a great cause. And if you'd like to see how you can help, maybe donate some money, check it out at miraclesinmoon.org. Miraclesinmoon.org. We'll be right back.
Are you overwhelmed, unable to think clearly or sleep well at night? Or just trudging through each day, but not really enjoying your life? I'm a counselor with Faithful Counseling. And that feeling of distress with a problem that seems too big or too impossible to overcome. Sometimes people or phone, even video conferencing today. Are you ready to shake this off and begin enjoying your life? If it's not for you, cancel during your first week and you'll not pay a dime. Go to TryFaithfulCounseling.com. It's time to talk to someone who can help. Go now to TryFaithfulCounseling.com. It's so easy to get started and your first week is free. Go now to TryFaithfulCounseling.com.
This is the John Steigerwald Show on AM 1250 and FM 92.5. The Answer.
Well, they're dropping like flies in local TV. John Burnett retired a few weeks ago. He's been around for a million years. And Ralph Iannone announced that I think today's his last day at KDK TV. I started there in 1985, and he was already working there. So that's 34 years at least. He's probably been there 36, 37 years. This guy was one of the all-time greats. I didn't know anybody who loved his job more than this guy did. And he never wanted to be an anchor. He didn't have the look of an anchor. He didn't have the voice necessarily of an anchor. He looked like a police detective out there on the street doing crime stories. And he came in. I think for all those years he worked the late shift, so he was on the 11 o'clock news, which meant if there's a murder, send Ralph. That's what he did. So I want to just wish him good luck in retirement and just say that. If there's a Hall of Fame of TV reporters in Pittsburgh, he's in there. And just a pro's pro and a newsman's newsman. You're allowed to say he's a man's man. He's a newsman's newsman. So I just have a couple of seconds left here, but I just saw a story today, a Pew Research, the state of the news media in 2018, U.S. newspaper circulation, lowest level since 1940, and local TV news is struggling. It's the audience has steadily declined 14%. This is across the country, NBC, ABC, CBS, and Fox affiliates that do local news. In the mornings, they're down like 10%. Late night and evening, down 14%. Midday down is also down 19%. This is not good news for local news. And I work for Channel 11, full disclosure, and I like the people there. I like everybody in the local news business, but I got some ideas on how they could do things differently, but they don't want to listen to me. But and murders on the air. But that's just me. I'll talk to you tomorrow, or Monday.
The John Steigerwald Show is a production of AM 1250, The Answer.
Community Bank.
City Mission.
Number 1 Cochrane.
Highmark Stadium.